It's through the ideas that he has pushed throughout his career on what's important and how to capture technology, how to capture the opportunities that are ahead, that is really going to change this country and really change the world as it already has. So without further ado, I'm honored to introduce not Gavin Newsom, but another great person who, Hilda, she stayed, okay? Ellen Tauscher, fabulous former congresswoman, former head of the Newsom. It must be safe here tonight because Ellen is here. Ladies and gentlemen, Ellen Tauscher.
So many people here that are friends of Gavin, or as we say in San Francisco, fog.
That's good.
It's everywhere. He is an enormous talent and somebody who, if you saw Morning Joe, if you saw Colbert last night, now he's here with us, so I think we're all very privileged. Citizenville is a great book because it's about government 2.0, and it's about Gavin's vision for how we should be working collectively for a better government and for a better opportunity for all of us. So I don't want to be between you and Gavin. Lieutenant Governor of California, Gavin Newsom.
Thank you again for your time and attention and your willingness to spend a few minutes talking about a book from a West Coast author from the great state of California. Just a little bit about the book because, I've been thinking about this issue of technology and government for some time, but I've been framed as so many politicians in the context of the issue around getting elected. And I think we're very good, relatively speaking, politicians at using the tools of technology to amplify people's voices, to get them out to volunteer, to get them to knock on some doors, to get them certainly to write some checks, and hopefully get out to vote on election day. But what we tend to do is once those voices get engaged and amplified, we tend to turn them off the day after the election. And we go back to this broadcast model. You vote, I decide. This traditional model that has existed for generations in all large institutions. It's the model, of course, we experienced for decades in the music industry, and the media industry, and it's a model, as you know, has been challenged. Newspapers are no longer the dominant means of communication. It's been challenged, certainly in the publishing industry, as now I understand more intimately as I've gone through this book. You've seen it with music, the ability now to download a song as opposed to an entire album. A generation now used to choices, not just standardized memes. Something new is taking shape in this world. Big, in many ways, is getting small in this context. Large, top-down, hierarchical institutions are being challenged more and more, particularly because of these tools of technology. I have a chapter in the book where we talk about the armies of Davids, no longer using slingshots, but in this case, the slingshot is technology, tearing down large institutions. Just think of the Facebook youth at Tahrir Square. Think of the indignados in Spain and what's happening, 230+ million microbloggers today in China, not just the Occupy movement or the Tea Party as we know it here in America. There's this sense of populism, this sense of change in the air, the likes of which I certainly haven't experienced in my lifetime, now amplified by these tools of technology, the ability now to democratize voices, these self-organizing communities that came together for the Obama campaign in 2008, 35,000 of them, self-organizing communities that continue to dominate our lives in the private sector, but increasingly now are going to dominate our lives as it relates to the issue of governing and governance. This is what we should be talking about, this notion that we should wake up every day and ask ourselves, what world are we living in? And what does this merger of IT and globalization mean to the life of not only our nation, but the world we're living in? And it's in many ways the inspiration of this book. So it was a great time. My contract, though, expired January 31st, and my last guest was Willie Mays, and it's one of the best shows, full hour of Willie Mays. That was not an easy get. And if someone wants to hire me in another network, I'm available.